恭喜恭喜恭喜
恭喜
恭喜恭喜恭喜 Harbor Times！
恭喜發財！
Do you know why do I have to congratulate Harbor Times？
Why is that？
Because you guys finally got into Bookazine。
Oh yeah, no, Bookazine's been a steady supporter. Yeah, for a long time since.
Exchange Square, Princess Building, Lyndhurst Street.
Yep, they're the only retail outlets that where we have it released. You know, it's very niche. You know, so but people can get it there. Yeah.
Well, last week I have written an article.
Tell me.
Saying that the chief executive did not announce the policy address.
Okay, did not announce it. How?
Yes, because he has announced the prelude to the budget.
Oh yeah, yeah. Well, that's
the cover of this issues of Harbor Times.
That's right. Tongue in focus.
Yes, but not the previous John. Not the Donald.
Not the Donald.
But the John.
Not the current one. The John. Yeah, that's right. John Tong. Yeah. So,
all right.
Policy address is old news, and now it's on to the budget. You know, if you want to have an impact, you got to have an impact on the budget because, you know, they're not going to go back and change the policy address. And so, you know, we looked at this and we went to legislators and think tanks and said, you know, given the policy address, what is the number one thing you want to see in the budget? And we got some answers from some people.
All right. What do we have?
All across the board. You know, and it's funny because sometimes some people had original ideas. So People Party came right out of the gates. And they very simple. $10,000 a person per year. All these other subsidies and things, they're big on this whole idea of, like, universal. Right? So they want to give $10,000 to everybody. Li Ka-shing gets $10,000. You get $10,000. Somebody in subdivided housing gets $10,000. Okay, that's their thing. You know, for me, I would probably prefer to concentrate resources on the poor, but that's people's problem. Lion Rock Institute, they came out and they had a few different ideas. They complimented the policy address for kind of a Milton Friedman-style negative income tax, giving money to working families. But they also suggested privatizing the airport. And they said, if Beijing has a privatized airport, why can't Hong Kong? Which I thought was kind of interesting, right? And I didn't realize that the Beijing airport was privatized. So, again, interesting. Paul Jie, also, you know, he's always got something interesting. He wanted tax allowance for domestic help, education, allowances for dependent parents and children, right? But this is an idea that's getting traction in a lot of places because if you look at, like, where people want tax deductions, everyone said policy address, nothing for the middle class. Budget, what are you going to do for us?
Yep.
And I think that's where the middle class is hoping for some
pickup. And I think that's part of the tactics, too.
Oh, yes. Could be, yeah.
Because for the grassroots and labor-affiliated political parties, basically FTU and DAB, they will say great to the policy address.
Sure.
But you also have the traditional establishment, like the Liberals.
Yeah.
Like... The NPP, New People's Party, and they want to fight for the middle class and the small businessmen.
Yeah.
So the budget can be another platform for them to say, we also get something for you.
Absolutely, which I think was also kind of the Democratic Party and Civic Party would also be trying to address the concerns.
Yep.
You know, and it's funny because when we look at, you know, what we got in terms of responses from people, you can see everybody's logos on there for where they put their digs in. But even groups like the Democratic Party and the DAB agreed on things like deductions for medical insurance. Mm-hmm. If the government wants more people to be less dependent on the government for their health care, you know, both the DAB and the Democratic Party are aligned on things like giving deductions for medical insurance, right?
Yep.
You know, the DAB, Democratic Party was also saying that we should give deductions to people for private pension schemes to support the middle class. The DAB went even farther and said that people, we should have more old age disallowance. But they wanted tax deductions for people for the rent, right? And this has been noted in some places. You get a tax deduction for your mortgage payments, but people who are paying rent don't get the same kind of support. And they're saying, why would we discriminate on that? And the DAB is saying, let's give people a tax deduction for the rent, right? So, you know, a lot of people asking for things to support the middle class, and we'll see what the financial secretary comes up with.
Well, I think tax will be key.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, for the middle class.
Yeah.
Every year during January.
Yeah.
Will be a big, big, big deadline for them.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
because they have to pay tax in January.
Have you paid yours yet this year? I'm guessing you're a taxpayer.
I didn't earn enough.
Not this year.
Oh,
well, you're starting a new business. I've got a tiny, tiny, tiny little bit that I've got to pay at the end of this week.
All right.
Yeah.
So last pick, budget.
All right, budget. Everybody keep an eye out for the budget.
All right.
All right.